Let's take up bonding in metal carbonyls. The homolactic carbonyls, compounds containing carbonyl ligands only, are formed by most of the transition metals. These carbonyls have simple, well-defined structure, and most of the carbonyl, the oxidation state of transition metal is zero. For example, tetracarbonyl nickel zero is a complex which is tetrahedral. Pentacarbonyl iron zero is trigonal bipyramidal, while hexacarbonyl chromium zero is octahedral complex. The first one we are taking, nickel tetracarbonyl. This is tetrahedral complex having sp3 hybridization, bond angle is 109.5 degree. The second complex is pentacarbonyl iron zero. It is dsp3 hybridization, trigonal bipyramidal structure, bond angles 120 and 90. Hexacarbonyl chromium zero is octahedral structure and it is d2sp3 hybridized. Octahedral shape, all bond angles are equal to 90 degree. These complexes form dimer. MnCO5 times, that is pentacarbonyl iron zero, forms a dimer. So this is dimanganese decacarbonyl. So here each manganese is trigonal bipyramidal and there is a bond between Mn and Mn. Same way, we have tetracarbonyl cobalt zero. It also exists as dimer, which we can name it as dicobalt octacarbonyl. Its structure is as shown above. Each cobalt atom is linked with 4 carbon monoxide molecules, and this cobalt is also linked with 4 carbon monoxide molecule tetrahedrally. So this is the structure of complexes dimanganese octadecacarbonyl and dicobalt octacarbonyl, which is used as catalyst in oxo process. The metal carbon bond in metal carbonyl possess both sigma s as well as p character, that is sigma bond as well as pi bond. The metal carbon sigma bond is formed by donation of lone pair of electrons on carbonyl carbon into vacant d orbital of metal transition metal. Pi bond is formed by donation of pair of electron from transition metal to vacant antibonding molecular orbital of carbon monoxide. So this is the type of bonding which takes place in metal carbonyl. The metal to ligand bonding creates a synergic effect which strengthens the bond between carbon monoxide and metal. This is the way how we are showing the pi bond is formed by lone pair of electron from carbon monoxide to vacant d orbital of transition metals. And sigma bond is formed by donation of lone pair of electrons from metal from carbonyl group to metal vacant d orbital of metal, whereas pi bond is formed by pair of electron presenting d orbital of metal to vacant antibonding molecular orbital of carbon monoxide. This is the pictorial representation of bonding in metal carbonyls. Next topic is stability of coordination compounds. The magnitude of stability or formation equilibrium constant for the association quantitatively expresses the stability of coordination complexes. And larger the value of stability constant, higher will be the proportion of product formed and more stable will be the complex formed. There is another constant called dissociation constant with or instability constant, which is reciprocal of stability constant. So higher the value of stability constant, lower will be the value of dissociation constant, and more stable will be the complex compound. This is the way how we are showing stepwise formation of the complex, which is shown above. Metal atom or ion reacts with ligand to form metal ligand bond, and K1 is product concentration divided by reactant concentration, product of concentration of reactants. Second step, another ligand joins, ML2 is formed, K2 is molar concentration of ML2 divided by molar concentration of ML into molar concentration of L. In third equation, ML2 takes up one more ligand to form ML3. So K3 represents molar concentration of products over molar concentration of reactants in this equation. The fourth step, ML3 reacts with one more ligand to form ML4, and K4 represents the molar concentration of is equal to ratio of molar concentration of product divided by molar concentration of reactants. K1, K2 are referred to as stepwise stability constant. Alternatively, we can write the overall stability constant that metal reacts with four ligands in only one step to form ML4. And here, beta 4 represents the equilibrium constant for this formation, which will be equal to molar concentration of product, that is ML4, divided by molar concentration of metal ligand into ligand raised to the power 4. Now, the relationship between the overall stability constant and stepwise stability constants are beta 4 will be equal to K1 into K2 into K3 into K4 and so on. And if there are n number of steps, then beta n will be equal to K1 into K2 into K3 into K4 and so on up to Kn. So this is beta 4, which is overall stability constant. If we take the example, the step involved in the formation of cupra ammonium complex, we have the following reactions. Copper ions react with ammonia to form, with one mole of ammonia to form CuNH3 complex. Two positive charge of copper ion is shown because ammonia is neutral. K1 will be represented by concentration of products divided by concentration of reactants. This will take one more ammonia molecule to form this complex CuNH3 twice, two positive. This is the second step of complex formation. K2 will be written as CuNH3 twice, two positive concentration divided by concentration of reactants. This K1, K2 are stepwise stability constants. Here, two more steps can be written, K3 and K4, in the same manner. So overall stability constant will be equal to K1 into K2 into K3 into K4. Beta 4 will be equal to cupramine complex, that is CuNH3 4 times 2 positive divided by copper ion concentration into ammonia concentration raised to the power 4. The instability constant or dissociation constant of coordination compound is defined as reciprocal of formation constant or stability constant. Let's take up example. Calculate the overall complex dissociation equilibrium constant for cupramine complex, given that overall stability constant is 2.1 into 10 to the power 13. Dissociation constant is equal to reciprocal of overall stability constant, 1 over 2.1 into 10 to the power 13. This comes out to be 4.4 into 10 to the power minus 14. Where K is dissociation constant, which is reciprocal of stability constant. So here, value of stability constant is high, so value of instability constant is low. Therefore, complex compound is quite stable. Importance and application of coordination compounds. Coordination compounds find use in many qualitative and quantitative chemical analysis. The familiar color reactions given by metal ions with number of ligands, especially chelating agents, for example, EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetate, DMG, dimethyl glyoxime, which gives scarlet red precipitate with nickel ion, or alpha nitroso, beta naphthol, cupron, etc. These are the ligands which form colored complexes with the metal ions by which they can be identified. Hardness of water is estimated by simple titration with sodium, ethylene, diamine, tetraacetate. Calcium ion and magnesium ion form stable complexes with EDTA, and even hardness of water can be removed with the help of EDTA. It can be estimated as well as removed with the help of EDTA. Some important extraction processes like extraction of gold and extraction of silver is done by formation of cyanide complex. In gold, we react impure gold with the potassium cyanide or sodium cyanide to form this complex in aqueous solution, and then it is reduced with zinc to get gold metal. Similarly, silver is also extracted in the same manner. We get the same complex AgCN twice minus, and which is reduced by zinc. Similarly, purification of metals can be achieved through formation and subsequent decomposition of their coordination compound. For example, this is Mohn's process for purification of nickel. Impure nickel is reacted with carbon monoxide to form tetracarbonyl nickel zero, which can be decomposed at high temperature to give pure nickel. Coordination compounds are of great importance in biological processes. Pigment responsible for photosynthesis, chlorophyll, is the coordination compound of magnesium. Hemoglobin, present in RBC, is an oxygen carrier, which is a coordination complex of iron. Vitamin B12, cyanocobalamin, the anti-pernicious anemia factor, controls pernicious anemia. Its deficiency leads to pernicious anemia. This is a coordination compound of cobalt. Coordination compounds are used as catalysts. For example, Wilkinson catalyst, which is triphenylphosphine rhodium 1 chloride, which is used as homogeneous catalyst in hydrogenation of alkenes. Gold plating and silver plating can be done on the articles with the help of potassium argentocyanide and potassium orocyanide in the form of solution, where metal ions can be easily deposited. In black and white photography, sodium thiosulfate, which is popularly called as hypo, is used as fixer, removes undecomposed AgBr to form a silver thiosulfate complex. Here, coordination number of silver is 2. Thiosulfate ion have got minus 2 charge, minus 2 into 2, minus 4, plus 1, 3 minus is the charge on this complex ion. This is a soluble complex in which silver bromide has been removed with the help of sodium thiosulfate. And that's why sodium thiosulfate acts as a fixer in the photography. There is growing interest in the use of chelate therapy in medicinal chemistry. The excess of copper and iron are removed by chelating agent D-penicillin and disferoxine B. EDTA is used in treatment of lead poisoning. Some coordination compounds of platinum effectively inhibited is used in cancer growth. They are anti-tumor agent. Cisplatin is one of the examples.